So the night of Sophie's injury, I was on call, and it was one of the very few times in the hundred of calls I've done since I've been here that I got a direct phone call from the on-call trauma surgeon. When a trauma surgeon calls your phone directly when you're at home, it gets your attention.
It was a day not much different from any other.
And then it just completely changed within like 5 minutes at the end of practice. Like, it's split second all it took. You know when you get a gut feeling? I had that gut feeling something was wrong. I was overworked a lot. And I dove off. Instead of diving, you know, straight, I dove out and down. And I don't remember much from that instance. I just hit my head and I blacked out. I tried moving my body, but I couldn't move at all. From my neck down, there was no movement. So I drowned for a little bit. I couldn't breathe. And you know, everyone always is talking about how you see your life flash before your eyes, but it's true. I saw everything I wanted to have in life and everything that I wouldn't get if I didn't get out of the pool. And there was just, I was completely helpless. My teammate saw me before the lifeguards ever did. And he pulled me out of the pool. They secured me, and my dad was the first person to be there before the responders even got there.
You know, you hear people say the out-of-body experience, and when your daughter is asking you if she's gonna walk again, I guess that's where I, you know, I just stood outside of myself.
He called me after the ambulance had loaded her up, and he said, you need to prepare yourself. It's serious. I went to the hospital, yeah. And I actually got there before the ambulance.
Mm-hmm.
At one point, she looked at me and she said, am I gonna walk? And I said, I don't know. And I said, it doesn't matter what the outcome is, that we're gonna be with you every step of the way, and we love you, and your job is just to get better.
It was obvious that she needed surgery. The combination of problems for a person in that setting is the damage has already happened, but also with bones still pressing on the spinal cord, there's ongoing damage occurring. And the sooner we get the spinal cord free without pressure on it, the better recovery potential there is. The surgery isn't just removing bone, it's putting in metal replacement devices for the bone that we removed to hold the structure up of her neck. So it's a pretty big surgery to take on immediately in the late hours of the evening. I think we started her surgery at about 11 o'clock at night.
For the longest time, it seemed that they were gone and we had no information. And then he walks in, I don't know, maybe 4.5 hours later.
It was about 3 a.m.
Yeah.
He walked out.
And he sounded very confident, yeah. And he just couldn't stress enough how rare it was for someone that with the type of injury that she had just sustained to have such a mild effect on her spinal cord. It was just virtually a miracle.
So the connection to Sophie's family was with my family, more so my wife's family. I actually realized that in the emergency department, her dad shared that he was a firefighter.
He said, do you know Bruce Bickley? And I said, oh yeah, of course. And he said, well, I married Dee Dee, his daughter.
He's told me, I think I took your picture. And I said, that sounds familiar. I don't remember, but that sounds really familiar. And he said he was gonna look into it.
And he has way more important things, probably, you know, bigger fish to fry, I guess. And he's thinking I'm nuts or something. But sure enough, I went digging. And I happened to get my first digital camera maybe a week or two before Dee Dee and Dr. Tyler Atkins had popped into the station when I was working with his future father-in-law. And he's like, hey, can you get a picture? You know, and we're like, okay, yeah, let's go in front of the fire truck. And that was in May of 2007.
It wasn't until someone else shared to me his Facebook post that he found the picture and put it up some months after the injury that I knew he'd found that I saw the picture. It's crazy.
He had been doing his internships all over the world, and he ends up back in Fort Wayne marrying his high school sweetheart and saving my daughter's life. all those years later, just 3 miles away from where I took that photo.
It was just such an important thing to have. You know, that hope that I would eventually be able to walk again at the time. Even though it was hard and I was in a lot of pain, I was very determined.
The number of people who come back to essentially being normal, function-wise, and independent is pretty low.
They were doing little things like, can you twinkle your toes the slightest bit? And she could at least feel the sensation as Dr. Atkins was taking a needle and grazing the bottom of her feet. And she said, oh, I can feel that. And it was at that point where she stopped asking, am I gonna walk again? She'd already made up her mind that I'm gonna be fine.
I'm so proud of her and impressed with her. And I think it has as much or more to do with her than anything else anyone did on the medical side, because no one was gonna stop her.
You know, being an athlete before I broke my neck, obviously I wanted to get right back into the game as soon as I could physically. And I think he understands me in that sense, is I'm gonna try and keep going and going and pushing myself.
But every time I've seen her, it's like, okay, what sport are you doing now? And it seems like she'll do whatever the limit of what I say she can do based on her neck. And her parents always look to me to put some reins on her aggressive activities, but.
And he gets that same level of hard work and determination, but he also knows where to like connect and say, okay, you need to slow down.
It was within 6 to 9 months that she was trying out for the golf team. And then a little over a year, I started clearing her to be more aggressive with lifting weights. And now she does very impressive weightlifting. I think she's stronger than I am.
I'm looking forward to a lot of stuff, you know. End of my senior year, we have a lot going on, lots of finals, not looking forward to those that much, but I'm feeling very good because it's like, you know, small things like being able to dance at prom. I never thought I'd be able to do that again, and now I can, you know, dancing on my own 2 feet and, you know, spending time with friends without being worried about missing out on something that I can't physically do. So it's a very big deal to me to just be able to live day-to-day life for sure.